It's Toilet Tunes.
Yay!
And now we pass.
It's Toilet Tunes. I'm your host, Sarah Morris. Folks come to my big green bathroom somewhere north of Minneapolis, Minnesota. And we sing a little, we talk a bit, we put it out on the internet just in time for your Friday afternoon. Stay Toilet Tunes. Stay Toilet Tunes.
And that was the pause.
That was nice.
It's good. Take a nice deep breath. I'm Sarah Morris. I like to sing people in my big green bathroom. People like Terry Walsh.
Hi.
Terry Walsh of the Belfast Cowboys and St. Dominic's Trio and of Terry Walsh.
Yeah. Someone's got it.
We're going to talk about all the things you do, but first we're going to sing this little Wilco song, this wise adult person love song.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Being in my bathroom.
Thanks for inviting me to your bathroom.
For bringing really the song. You really had to go. Mm-hmm. That's how it works. I loved the song. I am a Wilco, pretty much know almost nothing. Mm-hmm. And so I'm really glad when people, because there's a lot of Wilco. So if I was ever to try to get into a Wilco phase, it's nice to have someone say, here's one song, start there. And this with Feist on vocals.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's, I think it's a beautiful song. I remember when that album came out, people kind of went, oh, that song is terrible. What in the world are you talking about?
I read that when I was like learning about it. People were like, the people got mad. Uh-huh. And I was like, people are heartless and wrong.
Just wrong. I think, you know, it's it's so easy to when a new album comes out, just I'll be contrarian, I think. Yeah. But I think it's a really nice adult look at, we talked about being able to say to your partner, I don't want to know everything about you. It's, yeah, maybe those little things you're thinking I shouldn't really be part of at all. And that's okay. It's okay for you to be a person alone aside from our relationship.
Right? It's good to be a person.
It is.
It is good to be a person. So you are a person, but you're also a member of a band.
I am.
Can you tell, most people here know all about it, but just, we have some friends who aren't from around here, as we would say.
Oh, yeah.
So can you tell the friends who aren't from around here about the Belfast Cowboys?
Sure. Well, back in 2001, I lost my job and my then wife got pregnant with our first kid in the same week. And my friend Brian Swanson, who had been playing with Weekly, just in a go-nowhere, do-nothing band position, he said, maybe it's time we give that Van Morrison idea of yours a try. And okay, so we set out, and there were four of us. Dave Kirby, the drummer, is still in the band. He plays with us all the time. And we started learning Van Morrison songs. We already knew a few. And after about 6 months, we added the horn section, and we added my old bandmate Joe Lascota on keys. And we played our first show in 2002 on St. Patrick's Day at the 400 Bar, which is now gone. And first year was a little touch and go, but then we started gaining momentum, and now we play as much as we want and don't even have to travel to make money, which is really great.
It's wildly beloved, this band, so much so that you're about to celebrate your second, it's your second annual 20th anniversary party.
Yes.
Is coming up next Friday at the Hook Ladder.
It is. I think the Hook, they were a little, they didn't really get the joke that it's our second annual 20th anniversary.
I get it. So next year will be the third annual, and this
right.
is like beautiful.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's like some, when I turned 21 for the second time, that was a thing to celebrate. I mean, there's all kinds of ways to name something, and I like this quite a bit. So you, sometimes you're a nine piece.
Most of the time.
But
when
you
is
also
the Cowboys?
Can contract.
Yes.
And become
St. Dominic's Trio.
But you're not always a trio when you're St. Dominic's Trio.
Very rarely, yeah.
You're sometimes a quartet or something. So numbers
most
don't matter
time.
To you,
no.
is what I'm hearing.
No, not at all. I named that band the night before our first show when the booker asked, what should I call you? And my favorite Van Morrison album is called St. Dominic's Preview, so I said, call us St. Dominic's Trio.
Yeah.
Because we were a trio that night, but then after that it was, let's get some drums in here.
Right.
You know, so.
I love that. And even though you have this Van Morrison, like this foundation, you also do a lot of your originals.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not like a tribute band so much as, like, right?
Right.
I don't know. I mean, I feel like there's tribute bands, but Belfast Cowboys feels its own category.
I've always called us a cover band, a Van Morrison cover band, because.
Okay.
He's a little iffy, you know, as far as, I don't want to pay tribute to somebody. It's one thing to pay tribute to Elvis or something, like somebody that's dead and can't make any more mistakes. But, I just thought a Van Morrison cover band was the way to call, and kind of stuck with that for 21 years.
Yeah, and then you put your originals in and everyone goes wild.
It's working, yeah. They would sneak them in here and there and they can't tell. Which is great.
That is a good, that's always a good thing. It's like you want people to know, but then when someone's like, oh, I didn't even know it was original, and you're like, yep.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's the ours. Driftwood, so St. Dominic's Trio, not a trio, you play every Tuesday at Driftwood. So
yes.
This is awesome because whenever they watch this episode, like, today is the 12th, but you can watch this episode any day, and this is still true.
Mm-hmm.
That the next Tuesday you'll be at the Driftwood at 7 o'clock. And you do that, you raise money for...
Foothold Twin Cities.
Okay.
Which is a nonprofit that my now wife and I, second wife, second time's a charm, Amber and I started in 2015. She works in education. And she just saw families with a lot of hardship in her work. And so we put this nonprofit together and used the band as a fundraising vehicle. And we've helped a lot of families.
Yeah.
And raised over $100,000 the last couple of years. And every single penny. That's my favorite part about it. 100% goes to pay one bill one time for a family that's been referred to us by someone. So... it's everybody that helps with it, they're volunteers. Even the internet fees or any little fees, we just pay those, and that's our contribution. So, and the band plays, and they don't worry about the tip bucket. You know, they're just great. They are all on board with it. It's a good feeling too.
That's awesome. Yeah. And you share every week, I feel like, how much you guys raised on that Tuesday. And it's always like big, beautiful. People are out there being generous and wonderful.
They sure are.
That's fantastic.
It's jaw-dropping. I mean, I remember, I'll even see on Facebook some memories of Tuesdays past, and I'll be happy that we raised $300. And now it's like, man, we raised $1,300 this week. And so, yeah, it's grown, and we're still growing, I hope.
I love that. Yeah. I love that a lot. One other show we were going to talk about, we got spring going on, it's about to be summer, and people, a good way to kick the summer off is by going to Lake Harriet Band Shell. Oh, do they have music Tuesday through Sundays? Or do they have it, is it every day even?
No, it's not every day, I don't think. I think they... I don't know.
It's a lot of days.
It is. It
and
maybe
one of
half
the best days is going to be this day, which is June 3rd, the Belfast Cowboys at Lake Harriet Bandshell. So that's a free event. It is an event. You bring your family, you bring your picnic, you get your favorite takeout.
Yep.
And you get ready to like be in the sunshine dancing, probably.
Yeah, absolutely.
For sure dancing.
And probably want to bike there or take a lift.
Yeah, you can't park.
You know, you don't want to try and park. It can be tough.
It's true. That would be the hardest part of your night. The rest of the night would be easy peasy lemon squeezy. So much fun. But the parking is it's the thing. When we're on Toilet Tunes, I like to ask a few questions.
Okay.
The first question is, will you? You kind of have done some of these, but you're going to have to do another one. Tell me something good. Tell me.
Well, let me see. What is good today? Well, it's Friday.
Yep.
And I got to take off half day of work. So that's pretty good.
Sing in my bathroom.
Yes. Yeah, it's worth it. What else is good?
Yeah.
I get to go home and see my dog, Bob.
Bob.
Yeah.
Is his name Robert?
No, Bobby.
It's just Bobby.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, he came as Bobby, and we got him in July. And he's a very nice guy, and he's waiting to see me.
Oh, so. I love that. That is good. That's very good. Another thing I like to ask is, will you... spin us out to something you're listening to that's getting your ears hot. It can be new. It can be, you know, from previous incarnations of musical life. But what's currently grabbing you?
Well, there's an old song, and I told this story on Facebook, but it's so mind-blowing. I'm going to just do the abbreviated version of it here.
You don't even have to be abbreviated.
I was just in Amsterdam with our guitarist, Dan Kowalki. And we woke up expecting to come home and make it to the Driftwood to play our show on Tuesday night. And I put music on my phone, and Spotify was just rolling through. And the Paul McCartney song Venus and Mars came on. And then it stopped abruptly and went to another song. And I said, what happened? Where did... because there's a song called Rock Show that comes right after it. And I've heard that song for many years. And I thought, what happened? And I finally looked at the phone and I said, oh, okay. Venus and Mars on Rock Show are two different songs on McCartney's album. So I had to go back and play them from the album so that we could get the full effect. And we listened to the song twice. Dan and I laughed about it because it's kind of a funny song. And he says, there's a rock show at the Concert Gabot. And I had no idea what he was saying there. And then long hair at the Madison Square. And so we listened to that. And then we went to breakfast. And on our way there, we found out our flight was canceled. And we weren't going to make it to the Driftwood. But so we were going to have to spend the day in Amsterdam. And Dan reminded me that I had wanted to go to the Van Gogh Museum. Mm-hmm. And it's I had wanted to go there for many years. And never was able to do it. I'd been to Amsterdam 3 times before. Never made it there. So we go and we look online and it says it's sold out. And I said, yeah, right. A museum sold out? So I said, let's just go and try and beg our way in. Mm. And we got to the museum and I saw this green field of grass and a big majestic looking building. And at the top it said Concert Gabot. And
that's the reference.
There's a rock show at the Concert Gabot. And it was spelled funny. I can't even remember. Like, Gabot, G-E-B-E-A-S.
It definitely has double vowels for sure.
Yes, it does.
After you've heard Amsterdam.
But I looked up the lyrics and yes, that's exactly what he said. And we got into the museum because of that.
Good.
That was like, I told Dan, this is like a signpost saying you are right where you're supposed to be.
I like those.
I do too. Felt a lot better after knowing we weren't going to make it to the Driftwood that night.
Yeah, but I'm impressed that you were even good. Like, you were going to wake up in Amsterdam and then fall, like, end your day on stage. I mean,
that was
rough.
The plan. Well,
star moves.
The Driftwood's very forgiving. Our crowd, we can
just be jet-lagged.
If they don't get entertained, they'll at least get a good laugh out of it.
Okay, that's good. Well, I will link to those songs, but from the album, so that people can play them back to back.
Perfect.
Sometimes I'll go to listen to music on Apple or where, because that's where I'm an Apple girl, and it will like shuffle, and I'm like, no, I do not want to shuffle.
I hate to hear.
Uh-huh. Do not shuffle unless I tell you to shuffle, because I want.
Give me the album in order.
I just finished sequencing an album. I took time with that,
right.
And I presume the artist did too. That's my soapbox for everybody there.
Absolutely.
One last question, Terry Walsh, where are you learning right now?
Where?
Yeah. Where or who or like? I mean, where in the world? Where in your life right now is learning happening?
Oh, piano, for sure.
Ooh.
Yeah. I played piano when I was a kid.
Yep.
Took lessons.
Okay.
And then when I started playing guitar, I kind of let it slide. And I never was able to play anything other than C or G or F.
Sure.
You know, I was afraid of even playing an A because they're, for those of you that don't play the piano.
Black keys.
Black keys, yeah. I was afraid of the black keys. Not the band.
Right.
But, then over the pandemic, I was stuck in my little apartment with a keyboard, and I thought, might as well make some use of this downtime, and I started playing the piano more and learning more songs, and now I play it at the Driftwood every week, and it's really freeing, and it's exciting again. It's so much fun, and I'm still a little afraid of, like...
I was going to say, what's your relationship with Black Keys these days?
Well, I'm a little hesitant, like, playing a song in E or B, but... Not anywhere near when I'll do it. I might make a few mistakes here, but I've kind of learned that the mistakes are okay. You know, they don't sound as bad as they do in my head when I'm doing.
Well, that's true.
Yeah,
that's very true. Yeah. Oh, that's good learning. Mm. That's very good learning. Okay, so I'm going to remind everybody. Oh, I've linked below to where you can get your most recent CD, which One Magic Night.
This Magic Night,
which was recorded in One Magic Night.
In One Magic Night on. The day the pandemic pretty much started for us, St. Patrick's Day 2020. Yeah.
The show was canceled and you were like, well, let's make an album instead.
Yeah, let's go into the studio and see what we can do. We did a live stream and then took the recordings and good old Rob Hillstrom made us a CD.
That's awesome. So I've linked to that as well. And then there's tickets. Just a hair are available, just a few, but you should go. It's going to be amazing. The second... annual 20th anniversary show, May 19th at The Hook.
I'm glad you got that.
I get it. Under the canopy, every Tuesday at Driftwood. Terry's going to take all these awesome posters home. June 3rd at Lake Harriet. They're stickers, too. So you can wear them. I mean, maybe you want to put them on...
The back of my car, I think.
Yeah. This is the time of the show where I get to thank my Sarah subscribers over on Patreon. Woo-hoo! Love you all so much. So much love. Big, big love. Terry, thank you for coming into the bathroom and talking to us about your bands and about Foothold and for all the good you do.
Thanks.
Out there.
Thanks for having me here, Sarah. It's great.
Yay.
Have love fun. Love the bathroom.
I know. To the tune, most Fridays, just a few more before we take a summer break. But until then, stay tuned.
High five. High five.
Oh my gosh. Yes. No,
Terry. Let's do it.
Pressure.
Right-handed. Okay.
Okay. Yeah! Yeah.